Hello guys and welcome back to Excelsphere Academy. So myself Dr. Ruby Singh and today we are going to do lecture 10 from the replication of DNA. So guys, ये हमारे 10th lecture है and I hope आपने हमारे previous lectures देखे हैं because जब तक आप वो नहीं देखेंगे आपको आगे के आने वाले lectures नहीं समझ में आएंगे, ठीक है? इसलिए आपका पहले के lectures देखना बहुत जरूरी है. So it is a part of watch and summary series and really sorry for the delay because in uploading the lectures, as you know, like a kind of busy schedule over here and and lots of typing also, right? So teaching is fine and many of you have asked me whether I take online classes or not. Guys, I do take online classes. The only problem is that I don't have good network over here, okay? And dealing with a small kid alone, it's quite difficult. So I don't know when he'll get up and, you know, the timing won't match. And I don't want to keep you waiting also, right? So what I will just say is that maybe by August or September, yeah, maybe I'll start over that time. If you guys are targeting for this year, December's exam, then please join me. I'll be taking the classes from August or September soon. Okay. But if you guys have any doubt, like any topic which you're not able to understand, please ping me or you can just comment me like, ma'am, aap is topic pe ek chota sa video bana dijiye, hume samjha dijiye. I'm happy to do that. Okay. It might take 1 or 2 days, but definitely I'll do for you guys. Okay. So chalo, let's not further delay and start with our 10th lecture. Okay, so in this lecture we're going to talk about the sliding clamps. So we have already discussed about the RNAs, primase, DNA polymerase, types of DNA polymerase, right? Now we're going to talk about the sliding clamps. Now why these are important? Because these are the clamps, ठीक है, जो DNA polymerase को इसे push करता जाता है. So helicase आपका आगे जाके DNA को unwind करता रहता है from double stranded is making the single stranded, right? And these sliding clamps which sits behind the DNA polymerase. So you have got your right-handed shaped DNA polymerase and back at the back the it's like this. At the back the sliding clamp will come and it is pushing your DNA polymerase to go ahead and do the synthesis. Okay, so the function of sliding clamp is not only to push the DNA polymerase but also to keep engage the DNA polymerase onto the double-stranded DNA so that it can continue the DNA replication. If these sliding clamps are not there, what will happen? Very soon after, you know, synthesizing around 2200 base pairs of nucleotide, what will happen? There's a tendency that the DNA polymerase might fall off from the double-stranded DNA. तो क्या होगा? आपका DNA replication होगा नहीं, ठीक है? इसलिए sliding clamps क्या करते हैं? DNA polymerase को इसे पकड़ के रखते हैं and just keep on pushing so that they can continue the DNA replication till the end of the double-stranded DNA, ठीक है? So let's talk about these sliding clamps. Okay, so sliding clamps dramatically increase the DNA polymerase processivity. So हमने पढ़ा है पहले कि processivity मतलब क्या है, right? Now who is increasing, who is helping? It is the sliding clamps. Okay, so the high processivity at the replication fork ensures rapid chromosome duplication. So what does it mean? It means that it is ensuring that the chromosome duplication जो है आपका जल्द से जल्द complete हो, ठीक है? So as we have already discussed, the DNA polymerase at the replication fork synthesize thousands and millions of base pairs without releasing from the template. Now it is not getting released. Now this is because of the presence of the sliding clamps. ठीक है? अगर sliding clamp नहीं होता तो इतने सारे base pair DNA pol add नहीं कर पाता. ठीक है guys, please ये दिमाग में बिठा लो कि sliding clamp का काम क्या है यहाँ पे. So despite this, when looked at in the absence of other proteins, the DNA polymerase which act at the replication fork, they can add only 2200 base pairs. So ye kaise bada hai? Now this has been increased because of the sliding clamp. ठीक है? Okay. Guys, if possible, try to make your own short notes also. Already, whatever I'm providing is in the short, but if possible, make your own short notes also so that, you know, after once this chapter gets completed, you will have your own 2-3 pages short notes so that whenever you revise and sab kuch aapko clear ho jaye, theek hai? And do study with the help of the images always. So one key to the high processivity of the DNA polymerase is because of the sliding clamp. ओके, सो बहुत बार रिपीट हो गया है कि हाँ समझ गए हैं, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दी स्लाइडिंग डीएनए क्लैंप्स. सो दीज प्रोटीन्स आर कंपोज्ड ऑफ मल्टीपल आइडेंटिकल सब यूनिट्स एंड दैट्स असेंबल्ड इन द शेप ऑफ द डोनट. कैन यू सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्लाइडिंग क्लैंप ओवर हियर, राइट? So this is the side views, and at the center you can see this is your DNA and upper sliding clamp. So the opening through the center of the sliding clamp is 35 angstrom, and we know that the DNA ka diameter kitna hai, around 20. So this 35 angstrom ke center mein, what you see is the 20 angstrom DNA. Okay? So this provides enough space to allow the thin layer of the two water molecules between the sliding clamp and the DNA. So now guys, why always this water molecules are important wherever this protein DNA interactions are there, or wherever protein-protein interactions are there? So this is your one very important interview type of question. Okay? Sawal kya hai? What is the need of the presence of the water molecules whenever there is a protein-protein interactions or protein-DNA interactions? So the simple answer is hydrogen bonds. Okay? It is required for the making the interactions. It helps in the interactions. Zaruri nahi hai ki protein and DNA directly interact karenge. So they might interact with interacting with the water molecules which are present between them. Okay? So the hole in the center of the clamp is large enough to encircle the DNA double helix and leave room for a layer of one or two water molecules. Okay, I think this just got repeated. So these properties allow the clamp proteins to slide along the DNA without dissociating from it. Okay, so this interaction is also important, which is happening with the help of the water molecules. Now, sliding DNA clamps also bind tightly to DNA polymerase, which is bound to primer template junction. So abhi humne kya bola? So already aapka jo sliding clamp hai, it is bound to your DNA polymerase. Theek hai? तो डीएनए पॉलीमरेज को भी पकड़ रखा है, एंड वो डीएनए पॉलीमरेज जो है जिसने प्राइमर टेम्पलेट जंक्शन को पकड़ रखा है, राइट? सो इन एंड ऑल व्हाट योर डीएनए, डीएनए पॉलीमरेज, स्लाइडिंग क्लैंप, ये सब आपका टुगेदर इट इज इंटरैक्टिंग. Now the resulting complex between the polymerase and sliding clamp moves efficiently along the DNA template during the DNA synthesis. So you, here you can see you have got the template, the primer, the DNA polymerase, and the sliding clamp. So, and it is moving towards the 5-3' direction. Now, the question comes, how does the association with the sliding clamp change the processivity of the DNA polymerase? So, already we have mentioned that in the absence of the sliding clamp, what happens is DNA polymerase gets dissociates from the template strand. Okay? So, kaisa hoga? Sirf 2200 base pair it has been added, and uske baad wo gir jata hai, theek hai? And jab sliding clamp hai, to what happens is even though girne ki koshish karta hai, what happens? Sliding clamp usko wapas le aata hai. And kaisa rahega? Since wo wapas aata jayega, it will continue its synthesizing, and it is able to add many more base pairs to the 3-OH of your DNA. Theek hai? So by keeping the DNA polymerase in close proximity to the DNA, the sliding clamp ensures that the DNA polymerase rapidly rebinds the same primer template junction and increasing the processivity of the DNA poly. Okay? I hope now it is clear. So just imagine you have got the clamp like this. It is holding your DNA poly. So you will have two, right? For the leading strand and for the lagging strand. So it is holding both. Now what is happening? So even if suppose DNA poly after synthesizing 2200 base pairs, if it falls, what happens? Sliding clamp is there, which is bringing back and rebinding to the same DNA. And kya hoga? Continue, it will continue. So that's why the DNA polymerase is able to add thousands and millions of the base pairs. So once a single stranded DNA template has directed synthesis of its complementary DNA strand, the polymerase must release from the completed double-stranded DNA and the sliding clamp to act at the new primer template junction. Okay? Now, this release, ab kya ho gaya? It has reached the DNA pole, has reached the end of the double-stranded DNA. Ab wo sliding clamp ko chhod sakta hai aur naye primer template junction ko add kar sakta hai, okay? Where it is still continuing. So this release is accomplished by a change in the affinity between the DNA polymerase and the sliding clamp, and which is that depends on the bound DNA. Again, see, now you don't have the double stranded DNA further to be replicated. So what will happen? The DNA poly will lose its affinity for the DNA to synthesize, and eventually it will lose its affinity for the clamp, right? So we know that the DNA poly bound to a primer template junction has high affinity. So once it reaches the end of the single stranded DNA, the affinity will decrease. Hence, the other proteins, like for example, just listen to this. In contrast, when a DNA polymerase reaches the end of the single-stranded DNA, the presence of the double-stranded DNA in its active sites results in a change in conformation. Now, when there is a change, what happens? It reduces the affinity for this sliding clamp and the DNA. Con DNA polymerase. So here what is happening at the end of the single-stranded DNA, the DNA pol is losing its affinity for the clamp as well as the DNA. Okay, now keep this thing in the mind. So what happens? So when a polymerase completes the replication of a stretch of DNA, it is released from the sliding clamp. Now once it is released, what will happen? Now your DNA polymerase is free, but sliding clamps are not immediately removed from the replicated DNA. So guys, if you remember the chapter 8, where we have discussed about the genome, chromatin, chromosome structure of the DNA, right? So there we have discussed about the sliding clamp proteins like pcna, which is required for the histone modification. Abhi kya hua hai? Aapka sirf DNA replication hua hai, right? After DNA replication, the newly synthesized strands also needs to get modified, the histone modification, so that it can get wrapped around, right? Because abhi to normal form mein hai, decondensed form mein. Later it has to get condensed to form the chromosome, right? Now it is in the is the open thread, right? So if you remember, so there are certain proteins like pcna, sliding clamps. So those are required to bring your enzymes like HAT, histone acetyl transferase enzyme, so they can be brought to the daughter strand and they can also do the histone modification as it was present on the parental strand. Okay, so this is important, guys. See, that's why I'm telling all the chapters. It's not like this chapter is different from the other chapter. Mole Bio means complete textbook. It's one story. So already we have discussed. Now we're discussing the DNA replication, and you can see how both the chapters are interrelated. Okay. So now let's talk how the sliding clamp is helping. So sliding DNA clamps increase the processivity of the associated DNA polymerase. Okay. So the sliding DNA clamp encircles the DNA and simultaneously binds the DNA polymerase. So you can see it is going to encircle at the back of it and it interacts with the DNA polymerase. Now, if suppose this sliding clamp was not there, so what happened? There is a chance the DNA polymerase might get released from the primer template junction. But since it is associated with the sliding clamp, so it is remaining over there. So this association will ensure that the DNA polymerase will rebind to the same primer template junction and will continue the DNA synthesis. Now, once it completes, okay, the DNA polymerase will get released from the double-stranded DNA, but your sliding clamp will be remaining over there. And later, this sliding clamp, the other proteins, it gets associated with other proteins like pcna. It will recruit the histone modifying enzyme proteins. Okay. Okay. So this is the example of the different structures solved from the different organisms, the sliding clamp only. For example, this is from the case of the E. coli, this is from your T4 phage, and this is from the eukaryote. So overall, you can see that the structure is very conserved. So it is like, six-fold symmetry is present, but the only difference what you can see is the number of subunits which is coming together and making the sliding clamp is going to differ from organism to organism. So if you can remember over here, so these are the two copies of the beta proteins over here. Then here GP45 proteins in the case of the T4 phage. And here this is the trimer of the pcna protein. So the pcna is nothing but your sliding clamp protein only. Okay. So that is what is written over here. The that the structure is being conserved from different species. Like you can talk about the virus, bacteria, yeast, humans, etc. It has got the conserved structure, right? So you can see that in each case, the clamp has got the six-fold symmetry and the same diameter. Only difference is that the number of subunits which is coming together and forming this clamp is going to vary. Okay. Now, sliding clamps are opened and placed on DNA by the help of the clamp loaders. So guys, this is again similar to your helicase. Like helicase bhi aapka kya tha? It's a hexamer protein. So it also needed ATP molecules to open up and wrap around the single stranded DNA and then, to go on further so that it can break the hydrogen bonds between the base pair and help in the unwinding of the DNA. Same way, sliding clamps are again six-fold symmetrical proteins, right? So even those need to get open up so that they can go and bind to the DNA, single stranded DNA, and also interact with the DNA polymerase. Ab ye kon karke de raha hai? So there are other protein groups which are called clamp loaders. So clamp loaders ka kaam kya? It's like crab ke do haath ki tarah rehte hain. So they will be holding your DNA polymerase like this. So sliding clamp will come, along with the DNA polymerase, it will hold like this and it will push like this. And these clamp holders are present throughout the replication process. Okay. So in the next lecture, definitely I'm going to show you the video how exactly this replication is being initiated and how these clamp loaders, the sliding clamp, are helping the DNA polymerase to continue the DNA replication. Okay. So the sliding clamp is a closed ring in solution, but it must be open so that it can encircle the DNA. So you've got the DNA single-stranded over here and it should come like this. Okay. It's like a ring-like structure. A special class of protein complex. So those are nothing but the clamp loaders. So they help in catalyzing the opening of the clamp loaders. So of course, whenever you need to open or change the structure, you always need energy. And that energy is nothing which is coming from the ATP. Right. So the enzymes can couple the ATP binding and hydrolysis so that it can help in the placement of the sliding clamp around the primer template, the junctions of the DNA. Now, the clamp loader also removes the DNA. It also removes the sliding clamps from the DNA when they are no longer in use. Jaise hi wo stretch of DNA aapka synthesized ho gaya hai. अब वहां पे कुछ भी नहीं बचा है करने को सो व्हाट विल हैपन देयर इज नो यूज ऑन देयर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ कीपिंग द स्लाइडिंग क्लैंप ओवर देयर सो व्हाट विल हैपन द लोडर विल रिमूव इट ओके एंड दैट रिमूवल डज नॉट रिक्वायर द एटीपी सो लेट्स सी हाउ इट इज बीइंग डन डोंट वरी आई एम गोना टेल यू ईच स्टेप इन डिटेल ऑल्सो इन द अपकमिंग स्लाइड Okay, so when you don't have ATP, the loader is not going to interact with the sliding clamp. Okay, so this is your sliding clamp. And this one is the loader. So you can see that when it goes and interacts with the ATP molecules, it binds to the ATP molecules. So then that time what happens, your sliding clamp gets opened up. So when it is open, it goes and encircles the DNA. Now once it encircles the DNA, then since the ATP has been released, what will happen? Hydrolyzed, what will happen? It is in the ADP form. And then it leaves, right? So what is happening? Again, after some time, you need the sliding clamp. So again, yahan pe ATP aayega, bind karega, wapas wo sliding clamp ko attach karega. And aapka sliding clamp kya karega? Yahan pe DNA pol ko attach karega. And the process continues till the entire genome gets duplicated. Okay, so let's see the other figure. So here we can see that again, this is the loader. So we have got the loader over here. This is your loader. Okay, and this is your clamp, sliding clamp. So again, in the same way, like in the previous figure here also, what we see is that ATP is required to interact so that it is able to open the sliding clamp. Now, in the case of E. coli, it is called G complex. And in the case of the eukaryotes, it is called the replication factor C. Guys, this is really important. ठीक है ये पॉइंट आपको बहुत अच्छे से याद रखना है इन द केस ऑफ ई कोलाई इट इज कॉल्ड द जी कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड इन द केस ऑफ यूकेरियोट्स इट इज कॉल्ड द आरएफसी दैट इज रेप्लिकेशन फैक्टर सी ओके नाउ टू कैटलाइज द स्लाइडिंग क्लैंप ओपनिंग वी नीड एटीपी सो वंस इट इज बाउंड टू द एटीपी द क्लैंप लोडर इज एबल टू ओपन द रिंग ठीक है सो सी यू कैन सी ओवर हियर इट इज एबल टू ओपन द रिंग वंस इट इज बाउंड विद द एटीपी And at this, when it is able to open, now it can encircle the DNA at the primer template junction. So if there is a correct binding to the DNA, there are two things which is going to happen. The open sliding clamp is positioned so the double stranded DNA is in what will be the hole of the clamp. Iska matlab kya? Open ho gaya aapka sliding clamp and usme aapka DNA. So aise jayega. So ab usko aise complete kar sakte hai. Theek hai? Now second, Once this is everything done, okay, आपका DNA encircle हो गया sliding clamp से, now what will happen? Now the ATP hydrolysis will take place. Now because only an ATP bound clamp loader can bind to the clamp and to the DNA, the ADP form will dissociate from the entire complex, leaving behind the closed clamp position around the double stranded DNA, and it is helping the DNA polymerase to continue the DNA synthesis. ठीक है, guys, I hope this is clear. Let me just explain you once again. So you have got the loader and the clamp, sliding clamp is there. Okay. So now the holder is able to, the loader is able to bind with the ATP. So now this, what will happen? This loader is able to open up the slide, open up the clamp. Okay. Now it is able to open up this. bound with the ATP. So this will do what? It is going to engage with your, so this is going to engage with your double-stranded DNA. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे आपका clamp है, ये आपका double-stranded DNA encircle हो गया है. Now once this has been done, what is the next step? The loader which is helping the encircling of the DNA with the help of the clamp. Now the ATP hydrolysis will take place. जैसे ही ATP hydrolyze होगा, what will happen? It will lose its affinity to remain bound to the DNA as well as the clamp. So it will just leave. Now what you are having is the DNA and the clamp, and this clamp is now going to interact with the DNA polymerase. अब क्या है? बस continue करो अपना DNA synthesis. ठीक है? So I hope this was clear. So if you can understand the figure, like what exactly is happening step by step, then you can really, you know, understand. Because कैसे होते हैं ना, हर एक process के साथ simultaneously बहुत सारे pathways चल रहे होते हैं. So if you can just connect them and, you know, imagine them, then beautifully you can understand the cell. Once you understand the cell, you can appreciate how much work they are doing. So that's why we should also do the hard work. Yes. So what controls when sliding clamps are loaded and removed from the DNA? So what are those factors which is helping the sliding clamps to be remaining over there or to leave the DNA? Okay. So it can occur at any time at the primer time template junction. Okay. Now these structures are formed not only during DNA replication but also whenever there is a DNA repair event also. Okay, so guys, please, आपको ये याद रखना होगा, because when we study the next chapter, all these points are going to get repeated. Okay, so sliding clamp only be removed from the DNA if it is not bound by the another protein. So जैसे भी हमने पढ़ा था last में, जैसे PCNA sliding clamp है, so the other histone modifying proteins can come and bind because it is required for the histone modification, ठीक है, for the nucleosome formation. अगर if it is not interacted with those or the other proteins, like just like for the example, Okazaki fragment repair proteins are there, then we have got the DNA repair proteins are there. So if it is not bound with all these proteins, then only it can be removed from the DNA. Otherwise it has to remain over there itself. Even if DNA polymerase leaves the double-stranded DNA अपना काम करने के बाद, आपका sliding clamp तब तक नहीं छोड़ सकते जब तक बाकी proteins अपना function करके जाते नहीं है. ठीक है? Yeah. So guys, yes. So that's all for today. I hope you like this lecture. And if any doubts are there, please let me know. And if any suggestions are there, you can also comment me. So okay, guys. Thank you. Have a nice day. Here's my son. At the last moment, he also came to say thank you. Yay. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.